Philippine shares snapped their winning streak, ending today's session in the red. The index closing at 64.65, down about 0.8%. While Asian peers are mostly higher ahead of the U.S. jobs report out later tonight at 8. Joining us now, Sun Life Financial's Chief Investment Officer, Mike Enriquez. Hi, Mike. Thanks for joining us.
Hey, me.
Okay, so we're back to 6,400, pretty impressive rally from the low of 4,263 back in mid-March. Now, this rally isn't because of good earnings or economic growth, because both are expected to be bad, nor big bargains anymore. There seems to be a singular focus on reopening of economies that's sort of muting all other indicators that were once held dear by traders and investors. Don't you think so?
Yes, and definitely this is what we've seen as well in the S&P 500 before the U.S. starts to open. You'd see S&P 500 already rallying, I think, to pre-COVID levels. So similar to the Philippines, I think there's a lot of positive sentiment towards the reopening of the economy, easing of the lockdown. We are now seeing more movement in the economy. So hopefully that has created a lot of positive sentiment. And what's noteworthy in this rally is foreign funds have been starting to come in again, and we have also noted that volume has increased, in fact, from last week. So I think those are some of the indicators that this should be a good rally, but although admittedly it's a bit fast than what everybody has expected, and I think this is really pent-up demand for markets to really go back and recover.
So Mike, when you look at the movements, who's buying the market up? And I guess the more important question is, can they keep up?
Well, again, there's a lot of foreign funds started buying from the MSCI rebalancing last Friday. I think there were more foreign funds coming in, and locals have started to slowly come in again. When the market was down, it was the locals that were supporting the index. So I think right now we have been seeing a broader rally. So hopefully in the next round, we can see second liners moving higher and following the first liners in this recovery phase of the market.
You mentioned this twice already, Mike, that foreign funds are starting to come back in. I mean, we saw 3 days of net foreign buying and then selling and then we're at it again. So really it supported this market. In fact, if you compare the PSEI to its peers, we're actually up, what, over 15% since last week.
Yes.
Pretty impressive.
From the recent low, and definitely it's something impressive. And you can see the weight of foreign funds once they start to allocate some portion of their funds in the Philippine equities. You can see the impact on how the market can rally fast.
But isn't it the concern that, you know, as quickly as they can come, that's as quickly as they can go as well?
Yes, and definitely. But a lot of those who have cut their losses have done so. And I think when the market went down to recent low, I think right now there's really a renewed optimism towards the economy as they see that the Philippines can recover. And hopefully we're a bit on the optimistic side that the economy will recover faster than consensus.
But Mike, you know, we've got data from this morning and they're not very optimistic, especially the unemployment data for April. We hit a record high, 17.7% unemployment rate. That's over 7 million Filipinos jobless. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. That's what they're saying. What do you make of this?
Well, definitely that's expected. And it's a bit sad to see about 7 million lose their jobs. And hopefully a majority of those will just be temporary in nature as they reopen the businesses and hopefully they can get back jobs. And I think it's quite important for the government, for one, to have the stimulus bill passed and these small companies to recover with whatever aid they can help these companies to recover fast. And hopefully, once they recover, they can be able to bring back all these displaced workers and help the economy regain back. And again, that it's more important for the Philippines because we're a domestically driven economy. If we see workers losing their jobs, it will be a big dampen to consumer sentiment and spending.
Okay, so let's now go over some of the interesting corporate stories we have from late yesterday until this morning. Aboitiz Power is saying that Therma Mobile is going to physically disconnect from Meralco's system and deregister as a trading participant on the spot market effective July 15.
Well, yeah, I think it's it has been long awaited for Aboitiz Power to do that for this small power plant that they have. And I think since last year, it has been quite slow, and I think it will remain dormant, and probably they will look to rejoin the spot market by the end of the year when spot prices starts to recover again.
Okay, and what about on Mary Mart? Their 1.6 billion IPO offer period ends today, June 5. What do you think?
Well,
do you think that investors, the market, will reward this courage that Ingebsia is showing during volatile periods?
Well, again, the environment is not really conducive to having an IPO at the moment. But this is a grocery store, which again is one of the more favored sectors in the market. But then again, it has to go down to its valuation. And from what we have been hearing from some of the analysts, I think the IPO price that they are targeting is a bit on the high side. So there might be a bit difficult for it to be a huge success.
But of course, it's a pretty small offer, so it might be easy to prop up as well. We have this just in, Mike, Philippine Airlines posting a net loss for the first quarter of this year to about 9 billion pesos, 9.4 billion pesos. Not really a shock, huh?
It's not a shock, but again, the figure continues to be shocking on as we see all these companies report losses. And I think it's one sector that everybody is already expecting. I think this will definitely hamper and affect more jobs down the road. And clearly it's the how fast the economy can recover, how fast tourism can recover. And I from what I understand, they've restarted some of the flights, and hopefully that can help recover losses that they have in the months.
Mike, I have an interesting question. Why haven't we been seeing share purchases or company buybacks in the recent weeks? Is it normal for companies to be, it seems like everybody's on cash preservation mode right now?
Yes, but we have seen some insider buying during the recent bottom of the market. I think there were several companies started buying the near bottom. We've seen the market consolidate over the last months, so probably they would have stopped and accumulated more at the bottom. And I think it's a good sign that even the companies themselves think that the share prices are really undervalued. That's why they're buying. So I think insider buying, you follow that, it's a good indicator and a strong indicator that what you're buying on the individual names would offer some value.
And let's go overseas now. Trouble in Hong Kong, the semi-autonomous region, an economic powerhouse, Asia's financial center, as China proposes a new security law that could bypass the city's legislation. The U.S. has threatened to strip Hong Kong of its special status, citing diminishing freedom. I guess two questions there. One, do you think this will have a big ripple effect to other financial centers around the world? And two, is Hong Kong even as important today as it used to be? I mean, it used to be China's crown jewel, but China's changed so much.
Yeah, you're correct there. But I think this is something that we're watching closely at the moment and how this will unfold. And definitely it will have ripple effects on the financial markets because Hong Kong continues to be one of the centers in Asia, apart from Singapore. Even us, Sun Life, we hold our regional office in Hong Kong. So definitely there's a lot of things that might change as China claws back Hong Kong faster than their deadline. And Well, I think for one, we have seen the moves of China trying to develop other provinces to be financial hubs. And I think they're prepared well for this, for the eventuality that Hong Kong might not be their center of the gateway for mm-hmm. China to the rest of the world. Mm-hmm.
And final question, Mike, for all investors who are watching today, the market has gone up to 6,400 from 4,200 back in mid-March, just about 3 months ago. What do you tell them? Some are probably thinking, oh my goodness, I missed the train.
Well, I think it's really a welcoming surprise for this market to rally and rally fast. Mm-hmm. So you can see that sentiment can really drive markets faster than the actual recovery of the economy, and this is really the psyche of the market. But I think for those who have missed this rally, this 1 week rally, I think there's a lot of opportunity and volatility that will continue on in the next couple of months, especially the height of the second quarter earnings results. And I think a lot of it has been priced in, but once you see the actual reports, you can't help but the share price to react as well. Similar to what Powell reported today, we all are expecting that, but you still would react negatively to those negative earnings results. And of course, second quarter is the time that the economy was really closed. So there would be bouts of volatility. I don't think this will be a rally that will be sustained in the next few months, because there are a lot of sentiment driven moves and a lot of other news items apart from COVID-19. You'd have to watch out as well for the US-China trade deal and how it'll escalate. So a lot of things, the previous issues that have escalated prior to COVID-19 is becoming present and relevant again. So a lot of volatility, but I think for the PSEI, we have a target of about 6,800 given about average of 10-11% contraction on the economy, on the share EPS rather. So I think from where it is right now until our forecast the target, I think there's still a lot of opportunity and value for the market at this level.
So. Okay, on that note, thank you very much, Mike, for joining us this afternoon.
Thank you too, Mimi.